The new normal. Now, one might think it's in reference to us moving the lecterns away and now standing on this half moon. But it actually is a phrase for the financiers among us, coined by Bill Gross, the founder of the investment firm PIMCO, and was stated in reference to the financial realities following the economic crisis in 2007 and 2008. The phrase highlighted the problematic state of our low-growth economy coupled with the high unemployment rate. Now, I know it might seem a little random that I'm bringing this up, but I do so because the phrase itself, new normal, fascinates me. Normal, whether new or present or old, assumes that something conforms to a standard. Yet at any given point in time, the economy, with so many daily transactions and variables, by its very nature, is inconsistent and unpredictable. While the economy certainly shows trends and typical signs, to ever be considered normal seems kind of absurd. However, stating and believing that normal is unrealistic in an economy will no doubt lead to fear, anxiety, and panic, not exactly a plan for success in a capitalist market. But seeking normalcy is not strictly reserved for economic health. Using the word normal is a judgment applied to all sorts of things. Normal business hours, normal time frame to complete a task, normal amount of pain, normal intelligence, normal look. But what is normal? Now my computer, because everything goes through a computer today, right? My computer dictionary defines normal in relation to human assessment as one free of physical or mental disabilities. So, normal is a lens to determine one's limitations. Now, when researching further, according to the thesaurus, a disability can be replaced with the words defect, abnormality, condition, disorder, and affliction. So someone with a physical or mental disability, the opposite of normal on the authority of the English language, would make someone defective or afflicted. Yet like the economy, how with the uniqueness of every individual human being can a label like normal define any of us? Aren't we all trying to free ourselves from some type of affliction, sometimes apparent to everyone and at other times hiding within our own walls? That would make us each abnormal, correct? And what keeps us from acknowledging our personal flaws and, more importantly, not letting those flaws define us? Now, this past week in reading the Huffington Post, I came about an article about the What It Be Project, which seeks to build securities through insecurities. The undertaking began when a photographer, Steven Rosenfeld, photographed his friend Amanda with her greatest insecurity, thunder thighs, written on her hand and her staring into the lens. When looking at the photograph afterwards, Amanda expressed, "I am not my body image." And thus, the site and the project, What It Be, began. In the artist's own words, the What It Be project is a social experiment turned into what is now a global movement about honesty and empowerment. In today's society, we are often told to look or act a certain way. If we differ from those standards, we are often judged, ridiculed, bullied, and sometimes even killed over them. I started this project in hopes to open up the lines of communication and to help everyone accept diversity with an open mind and heart and empower those who feel they suffer for something they may see as a flaw. As an observer, just looking at the website, it seems to be an extraordinarily empowering and healing experience to say, I am not my weight, depression, anxiety, sexuality, religion, race, effort, pain, ADHD, autism, could ultimately be extraordinarily freeing. By admitting our differences, we not only acknowledge that there is no normal, but more importantly, exclaim that the realities do not, cannot, and will not define us. As the artist expands, this experience is not aimed for people to say, you don't deal with an issue. It is to spread awareness on what people like you and me go through due to society's paved roads. These are serious issues that some of us can live with, but many battle on a day-to-day basis. Now, within this week's Torah portion, Vayikel, Moses asked each Israelite for a donation of gifts and those who are skilled to help to build the Mishkan, the tabernacle, under the direction of Bezalel and Ohaliv. Moses did not express a qualification that only the normal can bring their gifts and talents to build this space for godliness to reside. Each Israelite has a gift, which is accepted. Each also has a flaw. Each is not normal. And it takes everyone's uniqueness, those aspects that respect and do not harm another, to be valued for God to be present in the world. Now, maybe this idea and the What It Be Project offers us a chance to redefine normal, as opposed to a judgment on those with perceived limits, capabilities, or abilities. Maybe this new normal is about the internal and external struggles, challenges, and adversity due to limited definitions. Instead of denying or hiding our internal battles for fear of being rejected, what if we embraced, discussed, and grappled with them openly and honestly? And by opening up, we help to define not only our worth, but someone else's worth, offering healing, growth, and a more full life. So I ask, moving forward tonight, go home. Define your greatest insecurity. Exclaim, I am not that insecurity. And with it, I promise, godliness will be found in your home, in your heart, and most certainly our world. Shabbat Shalom.